Dear friends, greetings to all. Today's topic is diagrammatical and graphic representation. Then types of diagram: one dimensional diagram, two dimensional diagram, three dimensional diagram, pictogram, and cartogram. And we are going to study one by one these diagrams. First of all, one dimensional diagram. One dimensional diagram, it is otherwise called as bar diagram. Here only height is given important and breadth is not given important. There are five different types of one-dimensional diagram, simple bar diagram too. Then a simple bar diagram, it represents only one variable, and here we have taken year and sales, that is recorded in diagram. Thereby you can find the the growth of the sales. Subdivided bar diagram means each bar is subdivided with a different segment. Here one example: the sales in north, south, west, east are taken into consideration. That will be represented in the bar diagram as like this, subdivided bar diagram shown here. So different colors for area has been taken, and that you can find which one is growing high and which one is with the low growth rate. It gives a clear idea. Then multiple bar diagram. In this diagram, two or more bars are there to represent the character. Here we find we taken a production of ABC products for 2010 to 2014. Now you find how it is represented with the different colors. It is represented ABC. Here you find the C is with the highest value. It is recorded here like that. A is with the lowest value. Then percentage bar diagram. It is like the subdivided bar diagram only, but it is converted into percentage so that all the bars are with equal heights. So we find here the conversion into the percentage for the years and different variable: profit, indirect cost, and direct cost. Direct cost constitutes more. Here profit is more for the last year, the percentage of profit. It gives a clear idea about the variables. Then deviation bar diagram. In this bar diagram, that below x-axis bar is going. This is, for example, profit and loss. Here sales and profit and loss is given 2012 to 2015. You can find from this diagram that sales in the blue color and the profit or loss in brown color. Loss is coming down, profit is up. In 2 years, loss means second year and fourth year plus, that is one year. Then two-dimensional diagram. Two-dimensional diagram means here the two side length, the breadth and height are given important. There are four types. Let us study one by one. Rectangles. Rectangles means that height will be, height will be same, but the breadth is changing according to the units represented or according to the time represented. For 6 months, low, 12 months means somewhat two times greater that bar will be. Here you have find the per units have been given like that. And here in the first one, the breadth should be low, and the second one, third one, the breadth will be somewhat greater. Two times greater from the first one. Then squares. Squares means all sides are equal, and the variable should be converted into square by taking square root. Here year and sales have been given, and the sales should be converted in with the square root, taking square root to represent sides. Here in this example you find square root has been taken, and the each bar with the same height and the same breadth, same length. So you can find the from the size you can determine the growth. Then circles means in the circle type, then it variable should be converted by dividing pi, that is 22/7. Then square root should be taken to determine the size of the square for each year. Here 2010 to 2015, 2010 small size, 15 high size, so that one can easily identify that from that high growth in the 2015 compared to 2010. Then pi diagram. Pi diagram means it is circle shaped only, and in the circle, within the circle, divided into different categories. I mean, here, one example, prime goods, factory goods, administration overhead, selling and distribution, rent profit has been taken. Then prime goods constitute more, you can find in green color. And the factory overhead, then as in brown color, profit in the, blue color. So one can get a clear idea which one is greater constituting. Then three-dimensional diagram. In three-dimensional diagram, length, breadth, and width are the three important things which are to be taken into consideration. Example, cubes, spheres, cylinders, etc. The next one is fourth one, pictogram and quadrogram. The pictogram means given in the form of picture. Here we have taken the animals and two forests, how the animals are recorded, number recorded from the date survey, represented in the pictogram form, means picture is there, so one could get a clear idea. Elephant, easily they can find, camel, deer, monkeys in forest A and forest B, how it is recorded only you can able to know. Then here you find the giraffe, lions, bears, forest A and forest B also you can easily able to find out. Then next one is the cartogram. Cartogram means that presentation in the form of the geographical area. That is, we have taken the railway map for representing the data to show as an example. Okay, thank you.